Beattyville, I love it, it's home.
Raise your hand if you think President Trump is doing a good job.
I am still confident in my decision to vote for him.
They need to kind of let him do his job. Just get off on his back.
Would you have a different opinion if Hillary Clinton won?
I feel like Hillary, she had the qualifications to be president. I wasn't ready for a woman president.
I voted for him. I was hopeful. I'm not too hopeful now.
We've had several new businesses open up. I don't think that it's so much anything that's going on in Washington. I think it's community pride.
And if it wasn't for your life, I wouldn't live mine.
You can't just elect a president and then sit here and just sit there.
Wait on them to make a change.
Wait on them to do something. You know, you got to help them.
Welcome back to Beattyville, Kentucky. President Trump won 81% of the vote in this county. When we came here right after the inauguration, there was a lot of hope. People were betting that President Trump could turn things around for them here, bring back jobs and prosperity.
The day of the election, everybody was excited. Fresh meat in the White House.
So we've come back a year later to find out if the president has lived up to their hopes. Are you getting that change you voted for yet?
I am seeing attempted change. I'm still hopeful. I mean, I don't think any of the problems that we have is going to be quick fixes.
Harold and Leandra Schaus live in Beattyville, Kentucky with their three daughters.
Amen.
Leandra's an artist. Harold is a mason. He drives 2 hours each way to and from work because the best paying job he could find around here only paid $11 an hour. It's steady work, but he's making less than he was a year ago. They invited us to this family meal nearly a year after we first met them following the election.
We were the ones that kind of fell in the crack.
Can Donald Trump help you?
We'll see.
If he brings some jobs in here.
He has insurance. I don't have insurance.
Now she's still hopeful, but still without health insurance.
Did you try to sign up for Obamacare this year?
Yeah, I checked, and it was like $600.
Obamacare is too expensive for you.
Yeah.
But you guys make too much money to qualify for Medicaid.
Mm-hmm. I'm stuck in the middle.
And you've got pretty sick recently.
Yes.
Did you avoid going to the doctor, checking it out for a while because you didn't have health insurance?
Absolutely. I've lost like 60 pounds in the last 6 months.
If nothing changes on health care, by 2020, does he get your vote again?
There would be a really, really good possibility because I see Congress standing in the way more than him.
I've worked 6 shifts this week, so I'm pretty tired. It's paycheck to paycheck every time.
Their 22-year-old daughter, Sarah, makes them immensely proud.
Your hope for them?
That they can find happiness without having to just break their backs like so many people have.
She and their two other daughters are a big reason why they voted for President Trump. They want their children to be able to find good work.
I have a degree in public health and a degree in human services.
You tried to get jobs in this town with your degrees.
Yeah.
And what happened? What were you offered?
Everything was like $8, $9 an hour.
But you have thousands of dollars in student loan debt.
Yep.
So the system isn't working for you?
No.
Sarah didn't vote, she says, no time because she was working 3 jobs. But she has been hoping for change, largely for her parents.
Here you are watching your mom go through this, not knowing what's wrong. And she doesn't have the health care she needs.
Oh, it breaks my heart. Like, I could cry talking about it. Yeah. Like, my mom is the best person in the world. Like,
she is.
She would give anything to anybody. And she can't get the help that she needs. And it's not her fault.
And you can't help
it. I can't do anything to help it.
You don't make enough to pay for that?
No.
Beattyville is a community that is struggling. According to the most recent data, more than half of the people here live below the poverty line, and a majority of the people in this county are on Medicaid. Beattyville has been home for you since you were born.
Home, sweet home. If you want to get back to nature, Beattyville is where you want to come to.
Larry Phillips is trying to tap into that, building cabins for tourists.
We have the best geological rock climbing area pretty much in the world.
His auto shop is struggling.
It's been a steady decline. You've lost some oil. We had a lot of coal mining.
Is that part of why you voted for President Trump?
Yes, that was a lot.
This coal facility, people kept telling us, reopened after the election. It's nowhere near big enough, though, to turn this economy around.
How has the president done 1 year in?
He has done, or tried, to do more of his promises than any other president.
He's tried, but has he succeeded?
No, he's not been able. I mean, it's been one stumbling stone right after.
Who do you blame for getting in his way?
A lot of the politicians. The way I see it, he is a normal person like myself, not a politician. He don't talk like a politician.
He's a billionaire from New York City.
He's a billionaire from New York City. He's not a politician.
He is. He's the president.
He's the president, but
he's a politician.
You know good and well he don't act like one.
What will it take for President Trump to win your vote again in 2020?
All he's got to do is run again, honey. He's done got it.
That's it?
That's it.
But that's not it for David Coomer. After voting for President Obama twice, he cast his ballot for President Trump.
He's not the man I thought he was. Really? He's not. He's overbearing, and he's not getting nothing done.
He says he's accomplished more than any president.
And he has not. He talks a good talk, but can he walk the walk? He said that he put everybody back to work.
Jobs with a living wage. That's what Coomer says would lift Beattyville up, not government assistance. For now, he relies on his father's VA benefits to get by as he takes care of his aging mother.
I'm not employed right now. If I went to find work, I'd have to leave here.
If you looked at really how much of the population that could be working but is not working, what would you say it is in this town?
At least 30%, not 35%.
That's scary.
It is. And it's that way all over these little towns.
Something else ripping at the foundation of so many communities, including this one, the drug epidemic.
The drug epidemic in our county leads back to jobs, because if there were jobs, people wouldn't feel forced to have to do bad things such as drugs.
18-year-old Cameron Brown knows all too well.
Last summer, there was a bunch of drug-related murders that happened, and Cameron's dad ended up getting killed. It bothered me real bad, so I wrote a song about it. There's plenty of people just sitting at the house right now praying for a job. You know, it's killing them. They want to work and they want to provide for their families, but they don't have the means.
A long time ago, a man named Bobby Joe knew it was about his time. So he locked himself up deep in a holler, spent his last days getting high.
Kentucky's crackdown on the opioid crisis has landed more people behind bars. So many more. While we were here in town, it was announced a big employer will reopen.
It's the private prison right down here. So yes, it means more jobs here. But it's because of the heartbreaking impact that drugs are having here and across this country.
Does President Trump get credit for the prison reopening?
Yeah.
No, shouldn't.
The prospects for the future generations of Beattyville right now,
mm-hmm.
What are they?
They're grim. They're grim because right now we're clinging to the past. The only way we're going to fix Eastern Kentucky is get entrepreneurship, is create jobs by people creating businesses.
And some are.
And some are.
It's time that our community is seen in a more positive light. And I think that's what my generation and the current leaders of Beattyville have decided to do.
We want to have a community that our children don't have to graduate and leave. We want them to see that you can live here and be happy and successful.
Did you think about leaving?
I have, but I love this town. This town is more than just where I grew up. Like, this town's my family.
We have to learn to support each other. We can't wait for, you know, somebody to pull us out of a hole.
81% of the people here voted for President Trump. What has he brought to Beattyville?
Well, he brought hope. Without hope, you have nothing.
People have been optimistic because they wanted Trump to win. They've actually put in an effort.
And once they seen he won, they took the initiative, you know, and they done something.
We're poverty stricken, but happiness is rich here.
Yep.
And if you're happy, you're rich.